I'd like to spend a few moments covering with you Vectra Cognita Detect and Vectra Cognita Recall and how they work in the Amazon AWS cloud. Now, organizations are making a large transition from a large number of on-prem workloads and bringing those workloads off to the cloud. They may have dozens or hundreds of accounts, thousands of VPCs where they were running different multiple workloads. And they've got a few choices with which they can go ahead and really monitor what's going on inside these environments. With Cognita Detect, what we're able to do is we're really able to utilize a brand new offering from Amazon, which is the Vpc Traffic Mirror. Utilizing the Vpc Traffic Mirror, this gives us the ability to go ahead and monitor those cloud workloads the exact same way that we would monitor those on-prem workloads previously. So no matter how many accounts we need to pull the data from, no matter how many VPCs those accounts may own, it just does not matter. We can instrument all of those workloads with the VPC Traffic Mirror, and this will go and this will give us all of the packets that our sensors actually need, similar sensors as we have on-prem and in the cloud, to go ahead and actually get that packet data. We simply deploy them on a VPC by VPC basis. They're simply just Amazon AMIs, Amazon machine images that we're able to go ahead and just simply, you know, deploy programmatically or manually as needed. We can associate those traffic mirrors with those sensor ENIs, and then those devices will then just go ahead and then capture all that traffic from all those that those workloads are generating. We've got a very unique coverage model in that we can go and we can be deployed on-prem and the cloud simultaneously, going to either on an on-prem brain, a cloud brain, or multiple brains, depending on the configuration that you might want. And then we'll be able to go ahead and then follow any attack that might start on-prem and then transition to the cloud, or vice versa, because we have that entire organizational coverage. So now we're in the Amazon AWS console. And what we're in is we're in EC2. So this is where all of our AMIs, all of our instances are running. In this case, what we're doing is we're running basically two boxes. We're running a cloud sensor and we're running a cloud brain. Now the cloud brain is this guy at this IP address, and it's providing this user interface for us so that we're able to go and interact with a Cognita Detect. And I'll show you that more in just a few minutes. The sensor is the receiver of all of the packets from the VPC traffic mirror. In this case, basically what we've done is we've simply gone ahead and we've set up a box with two network interfaces. ETH0 is our capture interface, so it's the one that's going to go ahead and be the ENI that's going to receive all of our traffic mirrors, and I'll show you that in just a moment. ETH1 is our management interface and just allows connectivity back to our cloud brain. Cloud brain provides a full user interface, provides all the machine learning, and it comes in two different sizes. It can either be an R5 4XL or it can be an R5 8XL, depending on the amount of bandwidth we need to manage. Now, we're talking about the VPC traffic mirror. Let me show you that here. I'm just going to move on over to the VPC section, scroll down to the bottom here. Now, what you will need to do is you need to set up a few different pieces in order to get this to work. The first piece that I normally set up is I'm going to set up a mirror filter, because you need one of those to start off with. The mirror filter is very simple. All I've done in here is said that for TCP, UDP, and ICMP, all ports, inbound and outbound, give me all the packets. So that way I can go and I can receive everything. Best use of a Vectra Cognita Detect is that we go ahead and we receive all of the traffic types. Once that's in place, we need to set up a mirror target. Mirror target is just going to be an ENI. So back over in the EC2 console, we're just going to create another ENI, and we're going to elect that guy as a mirror target. And then we're just going to go set up a real simple security group that takes UDP 4789, because all of the traffic is going to be coming in via VXLAN. That's the way that it comes in. Assign that security group to it, assign that ENI to our ETH0 of our sensor, and we're done. Last piece is the mirror sessions. We simply just go ahead and create a mirror session for each source workload that we want to monitor, and then we attach that mirror session to the ENI of that instance, and then we point it or we create what's called a TMT or a traffic mirror target, and we point that traffic mirror target is our ENI of our sensor that we've created in the previous step. And so that's all that's needed in order to go and be able to tap all of your cloud-based workloads within Amazon AWS.